As a quant, you have something special, an analytical edge that sets you apart from the crowd. You see patterns and opportunities where others see noise. Now, imagine having the perfect tool to turn that insight into action. Stock options. These financial instruments are a way to craft a payoff that perfectly aligns with your quantitative forecasts. By combining these assets, you can turn predictions into cost-effective trades. Options are all about choice and flexibility. At their core, they give you a way to control stock without having to buy or sell it outright. There are four fundamental option positions. A long call gives you the right, but not the obligation, to buy a stock at a set price before the option expires. If you think a stock is going up, a long call lets you benefit from that increase without having to pay for the stock up front. A long put gives you the right to sell a stock at a set price before expiration. This is one option if you think the stock's price will drop. It can be a form of insurance. If the stock falls, your put gains value. On the flip side, a short call means you're selling someone the right to buy stock from you. If you're neutral or mildly bearish, you collect a premium up front, but you have the obligation to sell if the stock rises. A short put means you're selling someone the right to sell you stock. If you're bullish or neutral, you collect a premium and are obligated to buy the stock if it drops. In summary, long positions give you rights and potential upside, while short positions give you obligations and immediate income. Quants use these four basic positions in combination to engineer nuanced option strategies. So far, we've looked at single option positions. If you have a straightforward view, like you think a stock will go up or down, one option might be enough. But markets are complex. Your predictions can be complex too. That's where combining options comes in. By using more than one option at a time, you can shape a payoff that matches exactly what you expect from this stock. Let's start with a classic example, the straddle. To build a straddle, you buy two options at the same time, a long call and a long put. Same strike, same expiration. Why would you do this? Because you think something big is going to happen, you just don't know which direction. Could be an earnings call, could be an FDA ruling. You don't need to guess the outcome, you just need the stock to move. The straddle is a bet on volatility. Let's look at the payoff diagram. First, the long call by itself. You lose the premium if the stock drops, but if it rises past the strike, the payoff increases with no cap. Now the long put. This one profits if the stock drops below the strike. If it rises, the most you lose is the premium. To get the straddle's payoff, we add them together. The result is a V-shaped diagram. If the stock moves up, the call takes over. If the stock moves down, the put takes over. And if the stock stays at the strike, neither option is in the money. You lose both premiums. This shape straddles the strike price. That's where the name straddle comes from. But keep in mind, you paid for two options. The stock has to move far enough to cover both premiums before you're in the black. You're positioned on both sides, ready to profit if the stock makes a move in either direction. What's the catch? The straddle sounds like a win-win situation, making you money no matter which direction the stock moves. Put simply, it can be expensive. You're buying two options at the same strike, right near the stock price, so you're paying for full coverage on both sides. That means the stock needs to move far enough to pay back the premiums before this strategy becomes profitable. Is there a way to lower your initial cost and still benefit if the stock makes a big move? Enter the strangle. With a strangle, you still buy a call and a put with the same expiration, but this time both options are out of the money. This makes them cheaper, so your initial cost is lower. The trade-off? The stock has to move even further before you start to see any payoff, and then even further still to reach profit. In short, the strangle is a more cost-effective way to bet on a big move, but it requires a bigger move to see that payoff. The straddle's payoff diagram looks like a V centered at the strike. The strangle's diagram is wider, flatter in the middle, with the payoffs kicking in further out. Remember, what you're seeing is payoff, not profit. You only make money when the payoff is greater than the two combined premiums you paid. Until then, you're still underwater. The straddle and strangle are both tools for betting on a move. You just choose how much you're willing to pay for it. In the world of YouTube, creators face their own kind of risk. We rely on advertisers to pay the bills, but there is great uncertainty and high volatility in this strategy. One of the best options to support our content is to join us on Patreon. If you want to help us keep creating, consider supporting us. Visit patreon.com/socratica. Your support helps us keep the learning going. The Straddle and Strangle are both strategies that combine two options. But options can also be paired with stocks themselves, opening up even more strategies. A classic strategy for stock owners is the covered call. It's an example of using options to generate income. Suppose you own 100 shares of stock. You plan on holding the stock for a while. You don't expect any big price jumps in the near term, which presents an opportunity to make some extra money, so you sell a call option on the shares you already own. This means you collect a premium, the price you're paid for that option. In return, you agree to sell your stock at a set price if the option is exercised. What's your hope? That the stock stays below the strike price. If it does, the option expires worthless, and you keep both the premium and your shares. What's the risk? If the stock shoots up past the strike, the option will likely be exercised. That means you have to sell your stock at the strike price, even if the market price is higher. Can you see why the name covered call is fitting? You're selling a call, but you're covered because you already own the shares. This is considered a conservative strategy. The worst case? You sell stock you already own, just at a lower profit than you might have gotten otherwise. The best case? You keep your shares and earn extra income from the premium. After expiration, you can even sell another covered call, repeating the process again and again. Another strategy that pairs an option with stock ownership involves buying an option for protection. Meet the protective put, also known as the married put. Suppose you own 100 shares of a stock. You'd like to hold on to it, but you think there's a chance it might drop soon. To prepare for that possibility, you buy a put option on that same stock. If the stock price drops, the put increases in value, offsetting the losses on your shares. The put option is literally protecting your stock from downside risk, hence the name, protective put. It's like buying insurance for your portfolio. You pay a premium, and in return you get peace of mind, knowing you've placed a floor under your losses. It's a great example of using options to reduce risk. The payoff diagram for the protective put helps you visualize this strategy. First, let's review the payoff diagrams for when you're long or short a stock. Just like options, stocks have payoff diagrams too. When you buy stock, your payoff increases as the price rises and decreases when it falls. It's a straight line with a slope of 1. When you short stock, your payoff increases as the stock falls and decreases as it rises. That's a line with a slope of negative 1. Now let's combine the payoff of a put option with the payoff of owning the stock. What do we get? A new diagram where the downside is capped while the upside is still open. By the way, does this diagram look familiar? It's the same shape as a long call option. That's not a coincidence. The protective put recreates the behavior of a long call by combining other components. In finance, we call this a synthetic position. A synthetic asset is built from a collection of different parts in order to resemble another kind of asset. Think about what we're describing here, essentially a Frankenstein's monster of a financial instrument. The four strategies we've seen so far all combine two assets. The Straddle and Strangle each use two options, while the covered call and protective put combine an option with the underlying stock itself. But don't limit yourself. You're not restricted to only two instruments. For example, by combining the covered call and protective put, we get a three-asset strategy. The collar. The collar uses these three components: the underlying stock, a protective put, and a covered call. Here's how it works. You own the stock, just like in the covered call. You buy a put option to protect yourself from downside risk, just like in the protective put, and you sell a call option to generate income. The call you sell and the put you buy typically have the same expiration date. The strikes are chosen so that the premium you receive from selling the call helps offset the cost of buying the put. If the call actually completely covers the cost of the put, we call this a no-cost collar. Why collar? Because it effectively collars, or limits, both your upside and downside. The protective put sets a floor on your losses, while the covered call sets a ceiling on your gains. The payoff diagram for a collar is a combination of both strategies. You have limited downside and limited upside. This strategy has clearly defined risk. You know your maximum profit and your maximum loss. Quants will tell you, at the heart of every option strategy are just a few fundamental pieces. Long call, short call, long put, long stock, short stock. These are your building blocks. What you're really doing is engineering a payoff diagram that matches your beliefs about the stock and your objectives as a trader. All option strategies are made by combining these financial elements in different ways. Let's explore a few more examples to illustrate. Bull call spread. Long call at a lower strike, short call at a higher strike. This is a directional bet. You think the stock will rise, but not too far. You reduce cost by capping your upside. Bear put spread. Long put at a higher strike, short put at a lower strike. Same idea in reverse. You're bearish, but you want limited risk. You pay less than buying a put outright. Iron condor. A short call spread and a short put spread, both out of the money. You're betting the stock stays within a certain range. Profits from low volatility and time decay. Iron butterfly. A combination of a short straddle plus long out of the money wings. The wings are constructed with a long call and long put that are placed farther out of the money. You'll maximize your profit if the stock finishes near the center strike. How is this different from the condor? Tighter range, higher potential payout. Jade lizard, a short put plus a short call spread designed to avoid upside risk. Profits if the stock stays flat or moves up a little. Each of these strategies is just another way to shape a payoff. You choose the ingredients, you control the trade. Options give you the tools to express a view, not just on direction, but on risk, reward, probability, and time. You don't have to memorize everything. You just need to understand the pieces, these building blocks, and what they do when you combine them. Have you enjoyed exploring the world of option strategies? Well, have you? Good. Because there's so much more to explore, we're building a quantitative finance course designed to level up your skills. Want to stay in the loop? Join our mailing list and be the first to know when new courses go live. Let's keep learning together.